Well, okay. I hope you are able to see the word file and me as well. So today, yes. Are you able to see me and word file both?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay, fine. So today we are going to discuss about only one historian. So it's going to be a short class about Will Durant. He was an American historian and a very well-known historian for his contribution to history writing. His period was from 1885 to 1981. And he, very important contribution like Arnold Toynbee, he has done is that he had made a very in-depth study of human civilization. And he was born in Massachusetts, 1885, in USA. And earlier he studied in a Catholic school. So he had, in the early phase of his life, he had an inclination to devote himself for missionaries organization. But then, he had scientific studies like Darwin, Huxley, Spencer, Haeckel, that has changed his mind. And he was, in a way, attracted towards socialism, as well as he thought of studying human life, human civilization in a scientific basis. He also studied ethic and philosophy. And he was, influenced by the personality and ideas of well-known philosopher Spinoza. Then he studied in Columbia University. There he studied this Darwin, Spencer, Haeckel, and later on he worked for New York Evening Journal. And this journal used to be published in the evening, and Will Durant was given the task of collecting information about the crimes that is conducted in New York City. And he was not very comfortable dealing with the criminals, dealing with the crime. Later on he left it, and then he started teaching Latin, French, English, and geometry at Seton Hall College in New Jersey. And later on he shifted to New York once again, and there he taught in a school, Ferrer Modern School, where he also became principal. He was very young, and then he fell in love with his own student, and that student, Ariel, she was very, very young, only 13 years old. And as teacher and student cannot marry, he was in love with her, and he resigned from his job. He left that school, and then he later on he earned his doctorate in 1917. He started giving lectures at different places and earning some money. And at the same time, he started writing book. Like the famous books written by him is his autobiography titled Transition, then Heroes of History, Life of Greece, The Lesson of History, The Story of Philosophy, Pleasure of Philosophy, and then Story of Civilization in 11 volume. But what made him very famous is his book, The Story of Civilization. And he says that he got an inspiration to write this book by reading the book by British historian Bakal. The Bakal has started writing book Introduction to the History of Civilization, and he planned to write a book from very ancient time to 19th century. But he dies prematurely, and Durant, when he read that whatever is work done by Bakal, he thought of completing this work, and he was already 41 that time. Before his Story of Civilization, the book that made him very famous, two of Durant's book were already published. The first was Story of Philosophy, and second was Pleasure of Philosophy. So that already made him very popular. But in 1929 onwards, he completely devoted himself to write this voluminous, very, very big book, very big text of 11 volumes, big volumes, this much big. In 1929 onwards, he started collecting data, and he planned that I'll write the Story of Civilization in 5 volumes, and each volume will come after every 5 years. But as he started studying, the work went on expanding, and instead of 5 volumes, now it came into 11 volume, and it was published from 1935 to 1975. So it took him 40 years of engagement. And his approach to study history is called as an integral approach or synthetic approach. He doesn't believe that the political history, economic history, religious history should be separated and studied. But he believed that there should be an all comprehensive study of the culture. And you know, he's the way he presents the material, he makes it appealing to the common people. One do not have to be specialized philosopher or you know have a lot of background knowledge. His way of putting the matter is very simple, very lively, and very dramatic. And generally, that is intended for the general readers. And his 10th volume, you know, out of this 11th, 10th volume, which is titled as Rousseau and Revolution, has won him a Pulitzer Prize. This is a very important prize given to the non-fictional writing. And individual volume, uski jo kitabe thi, is there anybody from Hindi medium here? Shraddha is from Hindi medium, I think. Well, okay. So, उसकी जो किताब है ये स्टोरी ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन इट इज ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू मेनी ऑफ दिस वॉल्यूम्स आर ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू मोर देन 20 लैंग्वेजेस. उसका जो फर्स्ट वॉल्यूम था द फर्स्ट वॉल्यूम स्टोरी ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन का भी जो अलग अलग वॉल्यूम है उसका भी एक एक अलग अलग टाइटल है. जो फर्स्ट वॉल्यूम था दैट डील्स विद ओरिएंटल वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द ओरिएंटलिस्ट हिस्ट्री राइटिंग दैट इज द स्टडी ऑफ द ईस्टर्न कंट्रीज. सो हियर यू नो द ओरिएंटल हेरिटेज इट टॉक्स अबाउट द स्टडी एंड कल्चर ऑफ द ईस्टर्न कंट्रीज एंड हियर ही गिव्स स्पेस टू महात्मा गांधी एंड चंग काई शेक दैट इज फ्रॉम चाइना. सेकेंड वॉल्यूम इज द लाइफ ऑफ ग्रीस वेर ही टॉक्स अबाउट द हेरेटिक कल्चर दैट इज ग्रीक कल्चर. देन थर्ड वॉल्यूम इज सीजर एंड क्रिस्ट. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट ऑफ डूरांट्स बुक. देन फोर्थ वॉल्यूम इज एज ऑफ फेथ वेर ही टॉक्स अबाउट क्रिश्चियनिटी ज्यूज एंड इस्लाम. एंड यू नो बिफोर हिम नो क्रिश्चियन पर्सन हैज स्टडीड इस्लामिक सिविलाइजेशन सो थॉरली दैट ही हैज डन. And he described the life of at Cairo and Baghdad in the medieval period and how those were the important centers of learning. So you know his approach to history is not biased towards waste. You know generally एक बायसनेस था हिस्ट्री राइटिंग में कि वेस्ट के लोग जो है ज़्यादा सिविलाइज है ज़्यादा प्रोग्रेसिव है और ईस्ट के लोग जो है वो बैकवर्ड है. लेकिन ही रिजेक्ट्स दैट थियरी. ही सेज दैट ईस्टर्न सिविलाइजेशन वॉज इक्वली गुड. पूर्व की जो सभ्यताएं थी इस्लामिक सिविलाइजेशन स्टडी ही डज इट वेरी थॉरली. Then fifth volume, he talks about the revival of knowledge in Europe and account of the migrated artists, how the artists have migrated and so on. Sixth volume is his discussion on the religious belief and the revolt. You know, there were revolts against the established religion. For example, Christianity was very well established, but there was a revolt against the practices in church, resulting into the coming of Protestantism, Protestant religion. Then seventh volume is Age of Reason, and that is contributed by his wife Errol. In fact, you know, the volume after seventh are acknowledged by Will Durant that they are contributed by my wife Errol. In fact, you know, Ariel has helped him in writing earlier volume also, but he was not realizing it. She used to just bring the book and read it out, so he thought he his own work. But suddenly realization came ki it is she's also contributing, and then here onwards they are joint publication by Will Durant and his wife Errol Durant. You know, in fact, they were so much in love with each other that they grew old together. And later on, when Errol was his wife was hospitalized, and Will Durant dies at home, and when she hears the news of his death, she also dies. They lived a very long life, more than 90 years. They survived, and they married at a very young age. Well, 10th volume is Rousseau and Revolution. For this, Will Durant was not only awarded Pulitzer Prize, but for that, he also was awarded Medal of Freedom by the American President Ford. Study of culture is very important according to him. And when it's quite challenging, he says that comparative study of different culture is very important, but it is equally challenging too. That is what he says, because you are brought up in a particular culture and you will be having a tendency to praise that culture and not necessarily that you will do justice to other culture. In his book, he unites culture and philosophy. He had sympathy for the non-European civilization, a first Christian who studied Islamic civilization very thoroughly. And he makes very small, interesting statement like growth of knowledge is the essence of history. Education is a progressive discovery of your own ignorance. You discover that you were ignorant. Civilization, it begins with order, grow with liberty, and dies with chaos. And his contemporary like Bernard Shaw, Bernard Russell, Mahatma Gandhi, they were all his admirers. And you know, he was free from any racial superiority. Like his book Heroes of History is a collection of 21 speeches, and it talks about Confucius, Buddha, Mahatma Gandhi, and Indira Gandhi. And he had humanism also. Like, you know, for Congress, he published the document called Declaration of Independence, which talks about that there should be equality. He also speak for the right of women. Then he believed that the philosophy should not be divorced from the real life. His work is harmonious. He integrates the different topics very thoroughly. But you know, he could not complete the work he wanted to do. In fact, he could write only up to the downfall of the Napoleon 1815. So Europe and Eastern countries were covered, but the history of America was completely left out. And before that, he dies. His integral and synthetic approach, I have already told you. So this is all about Will Durant. You need to remember the name of his book. Which volume? 10th volume that won him Pulitzer Prize. He worked for which journal? New York Evening Journal. And you will be getting that kind of questions. He was from which country that you should be remembering. So this is where we end our class on Will Durant. In case you are having any doubt, you can ask me.